Glory, hallelujah, it's time to go ape over love and light a new candle of hope. And so it's time that the Lord wants to come to us on breezes of His most tender mercies. And so it's time to let our light shine. Let it be bold. Let it be strong. But there is a problem. We must stand together or our light goes out. Because the truth is, we are like fiber optics. Together, we become a powerful force to be reckoned with. And basically, it is so bright, it's like a living lava will come at us. But separately, we have not that power to shine. So it's time that we have to switch things around, for we've been wixing up our merge. And so in this hour, it is time to realize that since hope is the very last thing that can be lost, people watching this video of love might say that I'm a dreamer like John Lennon. But we're not the only ones. And someday I pray that you will join us along with Red Ready from Calgary. His channel is Love, A Light, Red Ready. So that the world might finally be able to live as one. So in this hour, it really is time to celebrate. And I'm from Canada, and I welcome you to this love song of songs. And so in this hour, it's time that we all reorganize our priorities so that we can do important things of love before anything else. So let all people asking themselves how deep is their love come to see that love's greatest hope is that love inside all of us is it insists, in spite of all evidence, that something better is waiting for us. Hope, if we'll have the courage to reach out our love and to work for love's foretold changes. So let us fight for love's right to fight against all unloving ways so that we won't commit the unforgivable sin of letting our love to wax right cold. And in these days of love's foretold Elijah task of us all beating our sword of the spirit into the sickle for love's great harvest according to the book of Revelation, we must go deep. We must go fast, and none of us should ever look back. So we all need to ask, how deep is the faith of all loving souls, understanding that love's unbreakable hope is being able to see that there is light for us in spite of all the darkness? And how deep is the wisdom of those refusing to see that our arising new kingdom age dawn can only come forth if we'll allow it to flow like never before? So how deep is love's passion, ask yourself, that refuses to learn from yesterday, refuses to live in love for today, and always gives up hope for times of love's greatest blessings. So we must not let that light go out. So in this hour, straighten up my hair there. One thing for sure, welcome to a great 70s song from the Bee Gees that always brings awareness of the truest truth that all loving people who still have the courage to be gentle to others really deserve a love that is far deeper than any ocean. So let us all sail away on the most lofty breezes of love's greatest kingdom age hopes, for we must leave the safety of past shores to be able to be empowered by our love's living hope so that we can go out to the deepest deeps. For there alone in the deepest deeps is the Lord's shining, radiant treasure of excellence for us. Since that lion and the lamb is our hidden priceless pearl of great reward that can so easily be found by everyone seeking the kingdom of love first, so they can finally embrace love's most precious excellence of treasure. For such a glorious reward of infinite love is eternal, everlasting, and only it alone can prove itself to be unbreakable. Love shall always win at the end of the day, since deep love cannot be chipped away. For as we sail off and go towards His most loving, merciful embrace, our love can if it's deep enough, it can weather any storm. And for that reason, as it is written, our good shepherd over all the flocks of man, he now declares to all mankind his everlasting unconditional love. For that living victory of all who is victorious, he says, I shall be your God and you shall be my people. I shall forgive your iniquity and I shall never remember it again. I shall write my law and my love upon your heart. Beyond that, no one will ever need to be taught of me anymore, saith the Lord God. For all people of love shall know me, from the least to the greatest. All whose love is as a child moving, as a verb. Leave the land of the walking dead, says the spirit of prophecy. All those letting their love die, not being deep at all. It is they who would be tossed into the place where there would be weeping and gnashing of teeth. A lovelessness forever. And so people evermore of love shall be mine, and I will write my very best poetry upon their hearts, poetry in motion. And so praise the Lord, just as 1 John 4:7 says, all those who love are born again and know God, because God is love. The Lord says, because I am Lord of love, that desire of all nations shall now put down his deepest roots of love for all people, admiring the most amazing beauty of that living lily of the valley. For he is the blood-red rose of Sharon. And as that lion of Zion roars louder than ever before, he now says to all of his people of love, he says, I am your inner hero of heroes, as Mariah Carey sang. And my greatest blessing of exciting kingdom age hopes will manifest if my faithful few, says the Lord, will let their love become their heir so that they can live without inhibitions and have no fears. So may the Lord make a spiritual increase of love to arise within all people of peace, so they can be overflowing in love for one another with the golden rule evermore. So welcome to this hour of love's greatest shining power, love's great glory that's resounding from the brothers Gibb. For it came to pass that all four sons of Hugh and Barbara Gibb were fated to be a musical family for the rest of their lives. And as their music beautifully flooded the earth like a great flood of love, Barry, Maurice, Robin, and Andy, all four of them, they came to believe in our most majestic majesty of majesties in theory about love. And they might not have been religious, but love has always been a driving force for those four in their own ways. And in their own way, they all came, I believe, they came to believe that the Lord's word about love is true for all people. And for neither death nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, or things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, or anything else in creation would ever be able to separate any of us from the love of our God in Christ Jesus our Lord, especially since all those who love are born again of God and know him exactly as it is written. And for over 50 years, Barry Gibb, the very last remaining brother, he's been asking all in his audiences, all of his sisters and brothers of other mothers, he's been asking them the very same questions in his most favorite song of all, which is How Can You Mend a Broken Heart, written by Al Green. And Al Green, he said that the music of love is the message, and the message of love is all music of love, hope, peace, and faith. So Barry got the message. And so again and again, Barry Gibb has asked these questions. He asks, how can we stop the rain from falling down? And how can you stop love's brightest sun from shining? And what do you think makes the world go round? But his biggest question is, when Barry asks, so how can we let love mend all broken hearts so even loving losers can always win? And then Brother Andy declared by his songs of love that if all those of love just would give a little bit more of their love away than they're looking for, then their love would turn the key, since love isn't even love unless it is given away. And when the Bee Gees were first inspired for this love song of songs, the whole universe shook as the brightest illumination of love's grandest light of love flashed in the middle of the largest black holes all throughout all of creation. So may you all have love from love and hope from hope and peace from our Prince thereof. And may you also receive faith from faith and joy from joy and mercy from our living mercy. For it is Christ alone who is Jehovah Nisi, the banner of love over every single person born of love. So by their hit, How Deep Is Your Love, the wise shall always be glorified by its message of kindness being stirred up within in order to release love's greatest glory. For the moment that anyone wanders away from our living love of always, they automatically want to feel in their hearts again the beautiful music of love's most beautiful, peaceful peace that flows therein. And that will come forth for everyone with loving hearts. It'll be like coming forth on a summer-like breeze, just like God blows his most butterfly kisses towards us. So in this hour, the Lord's most fervent word of love's real exciting passion will instantly thaw out all frozen hearts of winter's coldest indifference, so that by love's sweetest harmony in the spirit, our Lord of love, that he'll be able to keep all of his own people of love really warm by his most fervent love. And then shall such Bee Gees lyrics teach all those who are wanting real deep love how deep their love really is. So let everyone always be true to the way of love's greatest hope of peace, as they ask themselves always, how deep really is their love, and how deep is their passion, so they can really mean to learn. Because we're living in a world of fools, breaking us down when they should all be letting us live in the way of love. Because love always belongs to all of us. So believe in love, because it's the door to every soul. For the light of love can easily start shining in our deepest, darkest hour, because our Lord of love is our Savior when we fall. And multitudes of fools might not think love cares for them, but when joy comes in the morning, the wise will know down inside that love really does love them deeply. And it's love alone that we all need to show. So let all those of happiness's nicest smiles keep their heart of hearts warm in the love of our Lord thereof, so that their hearts might really mean to learn the lessons. We don't want to keep going around the same maple again and again, because we are living in a world of unliving fools that wants to break down everyone else's love, jealousy that mocks the meat that it preyeth upon, when they should all be letting themselves belong to love, so that they'll never again need to ask themselves how deep is their love, since they were all fearfully and wondrously made in the glorious image of love, our Lord. And so please do me a favor and the world, pass on their message of love. It's in the music.